I'm here with Alex Howard, an open government advocate and author. Thanks so much for being with us as part of Truth on Trial.
It's a pleasure to be with you. Thank you for the invitation.
Great. So, Alex, is government more open now or less than ever before?
Well, it depends what government we're talking about. There are city councils all the way on up to the White House. And I think the arc of history has led most of these governments to be more open through the enactment of a lot of sunshine laws and the development of many norms for disclosure. As people know very well, there are aspects of our national government which are more open than they used to be. There are ethics disclosures. We have a Freedom of Information Act, which didn't exist 50 years ago. We have public meetings laws. And there's a whole other series of statutes, policies, and regulations which have led to people having more access to information and more ability to pull up a hearing on their phone or a live stream, to go to a website, to download data, etc. What the past couple of years have laid bare, however, is the extent to which there's proactive disclosures where officials, politicians tell the public what they want them to know, which may or may not be accurate, and mandatory forced disclosures where a judge makes a ruling saying that some kind of data, some kind of document has to be available, and whistleblowing or leaking, depending upon your perspective, where sources tell journalists what people in power do not want them to know, and then the journalists report it out, investigate it, and then inform the public directly, and then are protected by the law and are norms around the freedom of the press here in the United States to be able to tell the public what's really happening in the halls of power. There has been, I think, an arc towards things being more open, but I think as the public is also aware, technologies have also come along that have enabled people to hide what they're doing, whether it's a personal device that they make a call on, a burner phone, as people might refer to them, or personal or private email systems. Famously, of course, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton had a personal email messaging system. What people may not recognize is that that's a practice which is persistent across all levels of government, from the very local officials all the way up to the White House. And now we have the phenomenon of encrypted messaging and ephemeral messaging, which may not have any archiving built in at all. There's no way to use something like Confide, which automatically destroys a message, and have it be consistent with public records because there's no archiving built into it. So we're at an extraordinary moment where if governments wish to be transparent, they can pull up a live stream of a meeting. They can disclose a document. They can speak directly to the public using these extraordinary devices, or they can choose to obfuscate what they're doing. They can choose to take it out of official channels and remove any record of it being there.
Let's talk about the release of the Mueller report. I use the word release lightly because a big uncertainty is how much of it will be made public. I should let the audience know we're recording this on February 22nd, Washington's birthday, historic day for honesty in the country. What's your take? How much of the Mueller report will be released to the public?
Well, there's nothing barring the entire thing from being released under the statute. They're required to share it with Congress. Congress could then share it. I think that they should share all of it. Public trust in this administration is at historic lows. The world is trying to understand what happened. I don't think that we'll be well served if it's not. What I expect to happen is that we're going to see a legal battle. I think that we're going to see Congress do what it can in the House to get it out. You're going to see delaying efforts in the Senate. It's going to be portrayed as partisan, but I would hope that people would look beyond that and think what the public's right to know is. And my expectation is that one way or another, we actually will see something. Whether it's the entire thing, it remains to be seen, because there are going to be classified aspects of this.
Great. Thanks so much for those insights, and we'll be seeing what happens.